Hey, it's Nietzsche and Flux. It's Reified Valerie. The short answer to your question is Butch Flight. The long answer is they're afraid that transness is costing... So many GOP people are afraid that transness is costing them gays and lesbians. Which makes no sense to me. I mean, let's do some incident studies math here. There was a recent paper put out by Lynn Conway, which estimates the incidence of transfemininity, which, again, I mean, I'm using a gender term to refer to sex because the language is still sort of clunky around sex and gender studies, but the incidence of transfemininity is about 1 in 100, and the incidence of transmasculinity is about 1/3 or a little bit more than that. So 1% of the adult female population would be trans, give or take. Currently, 0.9% of cis women identify as lesbian. 29% of trans women identify as lesbian. I mean, I could get into all sorts of, you know, base, completely unfounded hypotheses about why that's the case. Frankly, I don't care. But the point is... The point is to all the cis gays and lesbians out there, you're actually not going to lose members of your community. We don't transition to straight. I think there were about 23% in a recent national study that identified as purely heterosexual. So, again, we don't transition to be normal. We don't transition to, you know, not be queer. I'm, you know, there's my girlfriend in the background. Say hi, Morgan. Yes, yes. And so forth. Oh.
Hi.
Hi. My girlfriend. My awesome, awesome girlfriend. And she takes a bow. Yeah. And yeah, neither of us did this to be normal. We did this to look in the mirror and not, you know, feel like, how am I going to make it to 40 years old? Let's see, what else? Yeah, it's age old, it's not invented. The fact that there's been a leap and bound in technology for trans people has kind of made it seem like this exploding phenomenon. Like, if you're cis and gay or lesbian, what would you... You would go to a psychiatrist and they would write out a prescription. It's like, you need more girl. You know? You need more boy. It's, you know, hang out at a Menudo concert. You know? It's not difficult. There hasn't been a leap forward in technology. There's been a leap forward in, you know, openness, but, you know, the amount of people who've been able to identify as gay and lesbian hasn't really changed. The amount of people who've been able to publicly identify as gay and lesbian has radically changed. But then, so in the last years, has the percentage of people who've been allowed to publicly identify as trans. You could lose your treatment if you wanted to be out about your gender. You were told to move to another city. Oh, and you couldn't be lesbian, and you had to definitely look like you were a great candidate for passing the moment you showed up to the doctor. Oh, and you had to be operative too. You had to follow their treatment regime to the letter, because it's not like you'd know what your body wants, you know. I find it particularly galling, of course, that it's, you know, second wave, well, they call themselves feminists. I don't know how someone can call themselves a feminist and then find all sorts of fantastical ways to dance around my body, my choice. I mean, Janice Raymond didn't just write a really transphobic book for general consumption, in which she outed a trans woman who was working at a lesbian music collective, Olivia Records, and she got death threats from other women, etc., etc., etc. No, the United States government actually commissioned her to write a paper on the ethics of transition medicine in the early 80s, and this led to most states and federal agencies defunding transition medicine from their health programs, which then was a pretext for private companies to delist it, because, hey, if the government's not going to cover it, surely we shouldn't. And yeah, that's where we get to now. And of course there's that ridiculous, laughable film, The Gendercator, about a world in the future where every gay person is trans. And it's like, this, it's true to some extent. There is a government that tries to do this. They're in Iran. They have lots of problems. Their failure to understand the difference between sexual orientation and sex being one of the few ones that they share with a great deal of the cis-GLB community. Yeah, that's why they don't like us. The first gay person I came out to said, why would you do that if you want to have sex with women? It's because it's not about social opprobrium. It's about my body. It's about what I see in the mirror every day. And it's about having some semblance of agency over that. Yeah, so I hope that answers your question. That's the reason. They are just, you know, they think that every single queer person will just decide that they'll take hormones and surgery and become straight. Or just hormones and become straight. Again, surgery completely optional. So that's it. That seems to be pretty much the basic concern. It's like they think somehow that transition is being proposed as a cure for queerness, when really it's making an awful lot more people, an awful lot more visibly queer just by who they hold hands with when walking down the street. And that's a good thing.